I'm going to show you how to send data from your Excel sheet to the email address that is listed on your Excel sheet. Now, I did this for a gentleman this morning, and he wanted the list of email addresses here, and then he wanted the data to be sent in the body of the email. And so this is the headers that are going to go with the email, and this is the data. Obviously, I've just made some stuff up here that will be sent for each individual along with the headers on the body of the email. So let me show you what I've done with my code here. And so I've defined my values, and I've set a bunch of things as strings, and Outlook as an object, Outlook mail as an object, path as a string, last row as an integer, x as an integer, and data and header and all the way here. So let's go down through this. I'm doing a for loop, or doing a while loop, and x equals 2 because we have headers, of course, on our email page here. And so I'm setting Outlook app equals create object Outlook application, set Outlook mail item equals Outlook app create item. And so edress is what we have in the A column here. So it's L, or cells equals X1, so it's in the first column. And whatever X is the count of the row we're at. And the subject equals sheet 1, so that is your next one over. So that would be the B column. And then, let me scroll up here so we can see this. And then the headers. So this is going to be on every one of your invoices. We're going to have the headers, which is a C, D, and E values. And so what I've done is I've set the headers equals sheet 1 cells 1-3, 1-4, 1-5. And then I'm setting the values equals to... So whatever X is, and then this is your data 1, data 2, data 3. Now, so what I'm doing is I'm sending an Outlook to the email address on the sheet because I've defined it up there. And then I haven't put a carbon copy or a blind carbon copy. And the subject is what we have here in the B column. And then, the body is what is the most important part here. So Outlook body equals, please find the requested information. And then this is the symbol for a carriage return. And then I'm putting, in the next one, I'm putting the header and then an ampersand, and then I'm putting two spaces in here. You might have to play with this depending on the length of your headers and your data to line it up. And then I have an extension on here, and then I have another carriage return, and then I have the data, and with the spaces in between the data. And then we have a carriage return, and then we say best regards, an Outlook, and then we run it, we say Outlook mail item display, so we can see what it looks like, and Outlook mail item send, and then we go last row equals last row plus 1, and then eaddress equals nothing, so it blanks it out, and then we go x equals x plus 1. Okay, so now then we'll go back up to the top of the loop. So let me quickly run this. I'll go F8 through it so you can see it go. So I'll bring it back up again because that was quick. So here's your email that we have just created. Please find the requested information, and then you have your headers, invoice number, balance, and date due. And here's the data that goes underneath it. And now this will, if you continue to run the whole thing, it will go down the whole list and send a similar email to each of your email addresses on your Excel sheet. So that's how you send data in the body of the Outlook email from your Excel sheet. Please subscribe.